Suspended former Terrorist Investigation Division Director DIG Nanaka De Silva appeared before the Presidential Commission of Inquiry investigating the Easter Sunday attacks today. At the outset, the commission questioned the former TID director on recorded conversations between himself and Namal Kumara, following which the recordings were played to the commission. The former TID director told the commission, "I was first put in touch with Namal Kumara by IGP Pujit Jayasundara. These recordings have sections at the beginning, the middle and the end missing. Namal Kumara's voice is there, but what I said is missing. An informant cannot try to behave like a superior. After a while, I became convinced that he was lying. It became clear to me that he was doing this solely for monetary gain. None of the names on those recordings were first mentioned by me. They were instead responses I gave in my attempts to find out the truth in his statements." The former DIG was then questioned over another of the audio recordings played to the commission, in which Namal Kumara can be heard speaking of a plot to assassinate former Special Task Force Commandant Ammar Latif. To this, he replied, "Right after this conversation, I slapped Namal Kumara and threw him out of my vehicle. I then called the IGP and told him that I couldn't work with such an arrogant person." Following another recording being played to the commission, the former DIG asked the commission chairman, "I would like to know what is the connection between these recordings and the Easter attacks." The commission chairman replied, "Nilantha Jayawardena told the commission that there was some friction between you and him. Due to this, there was no smooth flow of intelligence information. These recordings were submitted to the commission by him to substantiate those claims." In response, former DIG De Silva stated, "These recordings were in the possession of Namal Kumara. It was him who released these to the media and handed them over to the CID. Hence, it begs the question as to how they came into Nilantha Jayawardena's possession." Following this, the former TID director's legal representative commenced his cross-examination by asking him, "Did Criminal Investigation Department Senior DIG Ravi Senaviratna and its director Shani Abesekara, who were in charge of the department during your tenure, influence your investigations at the Terrorist Investigation Division?" In response, the former DIG revealed, "Ravi Senaviratna and Shani Abesekara did exert influence at times. Such influence went as far as being politically motivated as well. There were certain individuals from a prominent non-governmental organization in the CID during that time. If required, I will write down a list of their names for you. We were pressurized by human rights organizations over any arrests we made. I asked the IGP for a team of trainees to assist in our investigations. Shortly after this, I was arrested. After this, my team was questioned as well. The investigating officer in my team, who was in charge of the file on Zahran Hashim, is today in a mental hospital."
Liver Ayush, Karabuneti Dantale Paya, Shakti Mat Dattipalakat.